I know what produces the most oxygen.
Yeah.
In the world. Okay, from what I've been researching, it's trees. I don't know. I think it's trees.
No, it's plankton.
You know what is the world's most producer of oxygen?
I don't know.
Well, it's plankton. Do you know what it is?
I know they live in the sea.
They're microscopic organisms that live in the ocean, in the sea as well. They produce 75% of the world's oxygen. People think that tree produces more, but it's plankton actually.
75%?
Yes.
That's actually a lot.
Voici un très beau spécimen de Pyrophagus pêché à Durban sur la plage Treasure Beach.
Bonjour plancton orange.
Bonjour plancton violet.
D'où viens-tu?
Du Maroc. Et toi?
D'Afrique du Sud.
Comment ça se fait que nous nous retrouvions tous les deux là?
En fait, c'est simple. Toi, plancton violet, tu viens du courant chaud du golfe de Guinée. Et toi, plancton orange, tu viens du courant froid du Benguela. Et ici, à Pointe-Nord, nous accueillons les planctons de toutes les côtes atlantiques d'Afrique.
Ce bécher contient de l'eau salée qui modélise l'eau des océans. Nous allons mesurer le pH.
Donc maintenant, on va effectuer une nouvelle mesure du pH, mais dans l'eau salée avec du dioxyde de carbone. Et on voit qu'il a baissé à 6,4, donc l'eau s'est acidifiée.
On en déduit que plus la concentration en dioxyde de carbone augmente dans l'atmosphère, plus la quantité de gaz qui se dissout dans l'eau des océans est importante, ce qui explique que les océans soient de plus en plus acides.
Do you know what are the consequences about the acidification of the ocean?
Alright, so generally with that, so we do have animals that do have weaker shells because of that. So with increasing ocean acidification, that can weaken, it's easier for animals to eat them, and that's what causes the problem.
Do you know any threats of the problem?
Alright, so generally with plankton, normally when we look at animal threats, we look at numbers. But in this case, normally with our plastic breaking down into little microplastic pieces, it normally floats around, or particles, it normally floats around the ocean. So what then happens is with zooplankton consuming that, because they do feed, it moves up the food chain and accumulates. So it's bioaccumulation of that plastic in other animals.